until we get there. Damn.
Hey, it's just me, Jen Kim. I usually post on Sundays, but this is just a special midweek episode. I woke up today feeling all ready to be productive and got a lot of stuff done that I had to do, and then I read this on Facebook. It's the middle of 2016, and chink eyes is seriously a hashtag that is being used to describe squinting in photos. WTF is wrong with people. When I researched this, I found out that it has been used on Instagram about 34,000 times, just the last time I checked. That is amazing to me. I cannot even believe this is happening. I don't even know what to say. Some of my friends' comments were disappointing, maddening, pissed, deeply offended, hurt, lots of what the fucks, hard for us to say it or even type it. I'm sorry, it was 39,824 times on Instagram. I know when I was little, I was made fun of. I was called certain things that are not okay. I didn't realize that at the time, and people told me it wasn't a big deal, but it is a big deal. Certainly is a big deal. A girl when I was little in my hometown used to pull her eyes back, which I'm not even gonna do, and sing Chinese, Chinese, a yellow sack of Chinese. Just think about that. Just think about that. And being little and telling people and being upset and someone telling you it's not a big deal and making you share your toys with her, which I didn't want to do. So I was just thinking about this a bit and researching. Urban Dictionary has a definition. Chink eye, a disease in which one's eyes appear squinted. Chink eye, a telltale sign that someone is high. It's what happens to your eyes when you are high on dope and try not to laugh. Your eyes sometimes resemble those of Asians. Therefore, the word chink eyes is born. I saw an article about Papa John's calling a woman Lady Chink Eyes on a receipt. Chick-fil-A, an employee wrote Ching and Chong on receipts. And Starbucks drew Asian eyes on cups. I'm upset. I'm shaking. I know that a lot of the people in my community are sharing these feelings, and I'm glad we have the community to discuss it, vent about it. You can find some resources in my previous episode for where to go to talk to people, chat with people, discuss this with people, unpack it. So just some thoughts from the community. Laura Lee had a poem that says, "To the moron who told me my accent was hot, English is my first language, Korean is not. When I was younger, kids would always say, hey Laura, can you see with your eyes that way?" She tells us, "The first day of first grade, I had everyone on the bus make eyes at me by pulling the corners back. My mother told me kids will always pick on other kids and did nothing about it. This is the tale of my entire life, but I was constantly picked on for being adopted and for being Asian." I'm almost crying. "Kids would make fun of me saying that my real parents couldn't love me, so I must be unlovable. I had an 8th grade home economics teacher tell everyone I was found in a garbage can. I wish there was more education and resources out there because the bullying that I've received, I can only imagine others have received the same thing, and it is very shameful that anybody could treat other humans the way I have been treated. Even using things as jokes are microaggressions. As you can see, I do it to prove a point and also lessen the sting of what other people's views and words have said and then pushed on me. It's really nice to see other people have the same voice and that I'm not alone." Trish shared, "The first day of kindergarten when my twin and I were surrounded the second we got off the bus by older kids. We would be pushed off playground equipment and called chink or gook, and of course the eye pulling. Only got worse as we got older because we were in the same school system from K through 12. At best, teachers ignored it, but it was common for them to laugh along or encourage it." And for my amazing friend and writer, Kimberly Renee Herring, "Racism is alive and well. I'm actually stunned at the flagrant results of racism and the resulting apathy. I can't stand by and let my kids think the shape of their eyes is equivalent to non-Asians referring to their eyes as flawed in a photo. I need a sedative right now. Things that are worth fighting for are never easy to do. Every civil rights activist got shit and was told to sit down and shut up. When I hear the term chink eyes, chink eyes is what we Asians are called when non-Asians want to dehumanize us. Chink eyes is the Asians' version of the N-word. Chink eyes takes me back to the schoolyard where bullies could only think of something derogatory to say to me based solely on the shape of my eyes. Chink eyes classify Asian eyes as a flaw, an unwanted defect for non-Asians. Chink is the rice paddy squatting, bamboo hat wearing, I love you long time professing, buck-toothed, yellow as the sun, squinty eye looking, long duck dong sounding, geisha tea pouring, karate chopping, ninja star wielding, ancient Chinese secret, holding dehumanizing characterization of all Asians. So that's those are just some thoughts from our community. I did feel the need to make a tweet about this. Mine was pretty basic. It was not as eloquent as these were. And I also like this BuzzFeed article a lot, so if you want to check that out, you can go to this link. I feel like there's been a lot online lately about Asian stereotypes, Asians in media, Asians in movies, the starring John Cho hashtag, the starring Constance Wu hashtag, and just the things that we face every day, especially I'd say in the world of dating. A little bit crazy. This is a post on Instagram. And a message I received recently on an online site. I'm gonna get you Prego and we're gonna have the most beautiful mixed child, LOL. It's not funny, guys. I don't know. To me, it's not okay. To me, it's not something to be taken lightly. To me, it's not a joke. So I'm angry today, but I'm lucky because I have people to talk to. I'm having dinner with a bunch of CADs tonight. And I do feel supported. So it'd be great to see less of this. These are my eyes. These are my eyes without makeup. This is how I really look. And I invite you to use any kind of hashtag. Kim and I have been trying to think of one. Hashtag not a chink. I am not a chink. Oh, and seeing those hashtags, actually, they've been used by people showing their eyes blown up really large. And then they say not a chink. So I don't know what to do. If you have any ideas, leave me a comment, tweet me, email me, whatever you want. I'd love to hear from you and what your perspective might be. So thanks for listening. Have a good day. Sometimes I don't know where we're going until we get there. Also, I'm using this song Till by Dan Matthews, aka Dan, whose YouTube series follows him in his birth parents' search and finding his twin brother. It's called Till, and we're not there yet. Until we get there, I don't know what's going to happen. But again, leave me your comments, let me know what you think.
I'm amazed at what does it faze the faces of people raised in places homophobes and racist. Cause in my case I face it, I fall apart, be chasing love I never tasted, and hatred I am embracing.